In this video, we are going to create a really cool looking typographic kind of a text design inside of Photoshop, which is very trending these days, and you can use this technique to create different type of design that you like. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Pixartor, and without any further ado, let's jump into the Photoshop and get started. Alright, so here we are in the Photoshop. Let's take a new page and get started. So click on this file, click on new. Let's set the width of this page maybe 1920, height 1080, resolution 72 pixel, click on create. Select this foreground color, pure black, hit OK. Hold Alt on the keyboard, hit backspace to fill the black color on this background. Click on this lock button and unlock this background, and double click on that and let's call it busy for background. Alright, now we have to type a text over here. So select this text tool, go to character. If you can't see this character, then go to window and check this option character right over here. And we have to select a font style first. So in this case, I am using this Gotham font style. As you can see, we have this Gotham black font style, and I will give you the link in the description so you can download this Gotham font style, which is absolutely free for personal use. Alright, once you have selected the font, we have to set the size of this text. So I'm going to set this value 300 pixel, set it to regular, click over here and type anything that you want. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and you can select this white color, hit OK. Now just select this background and the text layer. Select this move tool, click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically. Basically, we have to set the text in the center of this frame. Alright, just close this character. Now we have to create a duplicate of this text layer. So select this text layer, right click on that. Click on duplicate layer right over here. Or you can also hit Ctrl J to create a duplicate. I'm going to call it 01. Hit OK. And now turn off this main text and just double click on the second copy, and here we have this field opacity. So we have to set this field opacity maybe 0%, and we have to click on this stroke, and inside of this stroke we have to set this white color, and let's set the size of this stroke maybe 5 pixel, which is good enough. Hit OK. After that, turn on the main text, and we have to place this second copy just below the main text. All right, and after that, just close this layer, select this one, and hold shift on the keyboard, press up arrow key, make sure your move tool is selected, and just place the text right over here, just like this. And let's create one more copy of this text. So right click on this layer, click on duplicate layer. Let's call it Apple 02. Now let's move the text below this main text. So hold shift on the keyboard, press down arrow key, and just place this text right over here, just like this. Let's select this Apple 01 and Apple 02. Select the both layer, hit Ctrl G to create a group. All right, after that, select this group one, click on this layer mask, and after that, just select this foreground color, pure black, hit OK. Select this paint tool, select a soft brush. Let's increase the opacity to 100%, flow 100%, and let's paint it by black color, just like this. Now it's looking nice. After that, we have to create one more copy. So what we have to do, just select this move tool, just select this group, right click on that, and click on this duplicate group. All right, now open this first group, select this Apple 01 text, hold shift on the keyboard, press up arrow key, and just place it like this. Select this second layer Apple 02, hold shift on the keyboard, press down arrow key, and let's set it just like this. All right, now close this group one, select this effect mask layer, select this paint tool, and let's paint it right over here. Just like this. Now let's paint over here as well. All right, it's looking nice. Now select this group one and group two, right click on that, click on group from layers and make a single group. Let's call it final, hit OK. And after that, select this final group layer, go to FX. Let's apply this gradient overlay effect. All right, and here we have to select a gradient color. So click on this gradient bar, select this first point. You can select any color that you like. Then we have to select the second point and select a different color and make a nice gradient color, hit OK. After that, let's apply hue and saturation. By using this hue and saturation adjustment layer, you can change the color very easily by sliding this hue value, or you can make it black and white by setting the saturation value negative 100, as you can see. All right, now let's close this effect. And finally, it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon for more interesting videos. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.